Today I have the pleasure of speaking with Abraham Drost from Carlisle Goldfields. How are you today, Abraham?
I'm well, Tracy, thank you.
Abraham, I was reviewing your biography this morning, and it is substantial. And I remember the last time we spoke, I asked you why you had joined Carlisle Goldfields. I'd like to ask you that again.
Well, you know, the invitation came about a year ago in November of 2013, after I'd left Premier Royalty, and my good friend Bruce Reed invited me to have a look at the asset. And quite frankly, I'd looked at it and I was quite impressed with the diligence that I did, impressed enough to become an investor, and then in February of 2014 to become CEO of the company.
Of course, you're doing everything you set out to do. You just announced a large strategic venture partnership with Orica Gold. Can you tell our audience about this?
Certainly. The new transaction with Orica, which was in the form of a private placement and a new joint venture on the Lynn Lake property, was part of a larger strategy to essentially resurrect Carlisle from what's happened in the recent market trend. And so in addition to the Orica transaction, which I'll get to, we also were able to attract research coverage through Paradigm with a 27-cent price target. And of course, the change of management, augmenting the management team, was a key piece of that as well. So now we have three pieces in place, and Carlisle is set to go forward. Now, with respect to Orica, you know, we received a nice cash infusion at 8 cents a share, about 100% premium to the market at the time. And in addition, Orica has contracted to advance a feasibility study on the Lynn Lake project.
Okay, and for all of those out there looking for companies that are defying gravity, Carlisle Goldfields is certainly, you're accomplishing this mission. And of course, you have a 43-101 on five different projects in Lynn Lake, is that correct?
Yeah, I mean, I think what attracted Orica to the Lynn Lake project was the two projects in particular, two assets in particular, the McClellan and the Farley Lake deposits, which are past producers. But in addition to that, prior to my coming on board, Carlisle produced 43-101 resource updates on three additional deposits. In addition to that, part of the deal, then, as I said, Orica advances on feasibility. Carlisle advances on further exploration as operator of the exploration side of the equation. And to do that, the partners have agreed to fund $4 million a year into exploration over the next 3 years, the earn-in period, to advance on 20 additional gold occurrences that we know about in the belt, but we've never been funded to actually pursue and test to see you know, what additional resources there might be.
And of course, they were probably attracted. I was looking at your NPV. It's what, nearly $300 million?
Yes, on the two assets, as I mentioned, the McClellan and the Farley Lake, there's an after-tax NPV of $250 million. I think that one of the most exciting aspects of those particular deposits are the grade equation. Farley Lake is an open pittable deposit with over 3 grams grade per ton, and McClellan is close to 2 grams. And I think that was a major attractor for Orica.
Okay, so they are planning on being an earn-in partner as well in your path to production. When will Carlisle be producing?
Well, really, the operator of the feasibility study and the path to development is Orica. The time frame is in their hands. Having said that, they have a 3-year earn-in period to go from 25%, which they now own by virtue of a $5 million purchase that closed recently along with the private placement. And they have the option now to go to 51% by spending a minimum $20 million over the next 3 years to advance on feasibility, and then ultimately to deliver a compliant feasibility study to Carlisle in return for an additional 9%, which takes them to 60%. And the partners would then go forward on a 60-40 basis. Carlisle would be a fully participating partner at that point in time. I would imagine that moment where we need to consider funding a production decision would be 3.5 years out.
Well, you, of course, have accomplished a lot of these mandates in less than your first year as CEO. Is this correct?
Well, you know, there's always a sense that can you know, when I look at a company like Carlisle, can I be of assistance? Can I do something? Can we do something interesting here? Do we have an asset that lends itself to the kind of effort that needs to go into this to really bring it along? And the answer in all those cases was yes, absolutely. The Lynn Lake project is a best-in-class set of assets, and I think Orica's has validated that recently with the transaction we closed.
We continually speak to our audience to watch when top-notch leadership joins a smaller company like Carlisle. And on that note, with everything you've accomplished in the last year, what should we expect in, say, the next 2 quarters?
So the management team at Carlisle are looking at strategic vision for the company. We certainly have a mandate to explore as operator on the exploration side of the joint venture equation, and we intend to fulfill that mandate. But we're also looking at other ways we can add value to the company. Certainly with 40% of what promises to be a very fine cash flowing asset, we may have a cornerstone asset to add value more on the in the context of cash flow and perhaps even acquiring cash flowing assets going forward. So these are some of the things we're thinking about.
Well, Abraham, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much, Tracy.